want to thank you for being here. Thank Councilmember McMiller for allowing us to utilize his space. You can't have a dream without a team.
Amen.
I want to thank my husband Tim and my daughter Taylor and all of my family, friends, and supporters for being here tonight and for taking this journey with me. I thank you all for being a part of Team Warren, Team Rochester. First, I want to thank God for all that he has done in my life. I also want to thank my friend, labor activist and leader, Bruce Popper, for his wonderful introduction. And of course, Dr. McMichael, my minister and uncle, Hayes McCleary, and all our clergy members for their spiritual guidance, support, partnership, and leadership. Without you and without him, our city would lack hope and would have given up the will to fight a long time ago. We are in the heart of the 19th Ward, standing on a once abandoned piece of land that has now been made new. This is the neighborhood that I grew up in, a neighborhood full of promise, a neighborhood that represents not only what once was, but what could be, with the vision, teamwork, and partnership. We are a stone's throw away from my grandparents' home, where my mother and my aunt still live. And for me, ladies and gentlemen, this represents Rochester. Yeah. You see, I grew up within 3 miles of here, in two separate worlds. And that exposure shaped how I have managed Rochester these last 3.5 years. You see, at my house in the 19th Ward, it was kind of a storybook neighborhood of diversity. In our little middle class world, my neighbors on one side were an African American family. Across the street was a same-sex couple. And on the other side was an elderly white woman. There were immigrant kids who spoke English as a second language, along with other kids of pretty much every race and nationality. Italian, Asian, white, black, Latino, living and playing together on the same street. Many of our parents worked at Kodak, Xerox, Rochester Products, or Strong Memorial Hospital. Less than 3 miles away at my grandparents' home on Jefferson Avenue, things were a little bit different. It was and still is a neighborhood full of promise and opportunity, a neighborhood where everyone looks out for one another. But it's also a neighborhood with many families had and continue to have structural and economic challenges. My grandparents, Cecil and Margaret McCleary, were a stable force sometimes in a sea of challenges. I remember people knocking on the door, no matter the time of day or night, for a shoulder to cry on, a helping hand, or even a warm place to stay. It was there that I learned compassion, that I learned love and understanding. It was there that I learned that it was our duty to help our fellow man or woman, because you never knew when you would need help yourself. Growing up in these two worlds gave me an amazing perspective on life, and it gave me an ability to feel comfortable traveling in between many worlds. It is why I am just as comfortable working to get things done in the boardroom as I am sitting on the porch on Jefferson Avenue. It has been my goal to bring these worlds closer together, because we are one city.
Amen.
We are one Rochester.
Yes.
We are one community.
Yes.
Everything we are and everything we have the potential to be depends upon us believing in each other and our commitment to take care of each other.
Yes.
Our ability to show love, understanding, and compassion. 3.5 years ago, We made a commitment to each other. I asked you to believe in my ability to lead this city to a brighter future. And you asked me never to forget where I came from, never to forget about our neighborhood, to continue upon building the great work of many prior mayors, to focus on rebuilding the relationship between our police department and our community so our neighborhoods could become safer, to focus on bringing jobs to our city, to bring better educational opportunities to our city, to build Rochester up and not to tear us down. And I am proud to stand before you as your mayor and tell you that we did it. And we did it by working together. Now, I will be the first to admit that we may have gotten off to a rocky start, but we turned that around. And no one can take away all that we have accomplished together. We said we would, and we did. We said we would focus on crime, and we did. We brought crime to a 30-year low. We reorganized our police department. We brought body cameras to our police force. We started clergy on patrol and rebuilt the relationship between our police department and the community. We said we would bring jobs to our community. And we did. Unemployment in Rochester went from 9% to 6%. We added 22,000 jobs and retained 8,000 others. We started employment training programs like YAMTEP and OTR. We removed barriers to employment by introducing VanPools and Kiva. We said we would bring more educational opportunities to our city, and we did. We increased preschool enrollment by 1,200%. We gave more than 1 million books away. We increased funding for our libraries and our recreation centers. We took our students on college tours. We started an Urban Fellows internship program. We got our students more than $2 million in scholarships to historically black colleges and universities. We said we would find many ways to make our city more desirable to important millennials. We value a city that is walkable and bikeable, where they can live, work, and play. And the data shows that millennials are choosing Rochester. We said we would invest in our neighborhoods, and we did. New commercial buildings and new housing are being built or renovated in every part of our city. On Hudson Avenue, East Main Street, Grape Street, downtown, in the Interloop, and along the riverfront. We are tearing down dilapidated structures and making way for new opportunities all over our city. We said we would fight for all Rochesterians, and we did. We extended city health benefits to include transgender employees, and we're pushing our state to pass gender. We joined the fight to end the R word. We adopted the Ban the Box ordinance so people who've been in the criminal justice system but paid their dues to society aren't disqualified from city employment before they even fill out an application. We said we would stand firm against structural and economic barriers, and we did. We terminated the red light camera program. Businesses, and we're calling on the creation of a traffic court to give our citizens the access to the same rights as their friends and neighbors who live in the suburbs. Amen. We said we would bring strong fiscal management to City Hall, and we did. We held property taxes flat for residential property owners with City Council's help, And we have had our bond rating upgraded by 2 rating agencies. We said we would, and we did. We have done all of this in 3.5 years and much, much more. Did for every resident,
amen.
Regardless of what they look like, amen. Where they were born, how they worship, amen. Who they love, or what challenges they've had to overcome.
Amen.
That is why I am so proud to stand before all of you today and to say that it has been a good fight,
amen.
A fight that we are winning because our city, our children, our families are worth fighting for.
Amen.
And that is why I'm standing before you in my old neighborhood, a neighborhood that I love, to tell you all, I am seeking re-election. Incredibly strong foundation to do it on.
Amen.
Because in the next 4 years, I intend to bring more development, particularly more quality and affordable housing to every corner of our city.
Amen.
We will reignite our retail and commercial corridors, like the other end of Genesee Street at Bull's Head, where we have secured land, conducted environmental cleanups, and are removing old structures to pave the way for new jobs and development. Working with our partners in government, and most importantly, also with our residents, we will continue to make Rochester a city where all of our citizens can be proud of our efforts to bring more jobs, make neighborhoods safer, and better educational opportunities to our children. 4 years ago, some told me that we couldn't win, that we couldn't change Rochester, that we couldn't bring these two worlds together, that we needed to go along to get along, that we couldn't challenge the status quo, that we couldn't speak truth to power. They underestimated us then, and they are underestimating us again. We the people of Rochester, have accomplished so much together. And I believe that if we keep working together, we will and can accomplish so much more.
Yes.
Rochester, let me be very real and very candid with you. There are some, and many even in my own Democratic Party, that didn't want us to succeed. Even after we won the primary, they continue to try to defeat us. And these same people are at it again. Spewing lies, telling half truth, making up alternative facts. They have told us that we will not get the Democratic designation. To them, success is a finite resource, something that has limits. To them, there's only so much success to go around, and they want to make sure that they are in position to decide who should be successful and who shouldn't. But I will go through the designation process because despite those people, I believe in our democratic process. And it's not like we haven't been here before. And I refuse to concede anything. You elected me to stand up for you. Come hell or high water, I will stand up for you. I will stand up for you. the people's mayor.
Yes.
And like Shirley Chisholm, I am unbought and unbought. Some people had to learn that the hard way. Just like my mentor David Gant taught me, they don't control me and they don't control you. I work for the people of Rochester. Amen. You decided that 4 years ago, and you will decide that again. I don't believe that our work is done. And if you're kind enough to reelect me, I will continue to fight for you, and we will continue to grow stronger. Now, I'm not naive. I know this campaign will be a difficult one, but I can assure you that I have never ran from a fight, and I don't plan on running now. I am not scared off by hard work, and I've never been intimidated by those who have tried to control or bully me. I have been serving this community and our Democratic Party for almost 20 years. I believe that now more than ever, we must protect our progressive democratic values.
Yes.
Because the election of Donald Trump was a wake-up call for many of us. It has forced Democrats like me to re-examine our beliefs. And I can tell you, I have never been more proud of my beliefs than I am right now. I was proud to campaign for Secretary Clinton this past year, both here and in swing states across the country. I was proud to work with President Obama on initiatives like My Brother's Keeper, the IMCP, Veterans Housing, and Reach Higher for our high school student graduates. I was proud to stand in Washington Square Park the day after this presidential inauguration with thousands of people from Rochester in solidarity with hundreds of thousands of people from all across our country at the Women's March to protest Trump's sexist policies. I was proud to stand on the steps of City Hall beneath a banner that said, "We are a sanctuary city." It filled my heart with pride to see so many people brave the bitter cold to protest Trump's bigoted and racist immigration policies. I was proud to stand with our union brothers and sisters as they led the fight for 15.
That's it.
I love being mayor of our city, but most of all, I love knowing that the city of Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony is still standing for social justice and equal protection under the law. I love knowing that our democratic principles are alive and well in Rochester. They may try to silence the Democratic Party in Washington. They may try to dismantle the legacy of President Obama. They may even try to disparage my own accomplishments here at home. But I refuse to be silenced. Like Elizabeth Warren, I may have been warned, but I will persist. We will persist, Rochester. I am an African-American woman and the child of an immigrant. I am keenly aware of what discrimination looks like, and equally aware that it has no place in the American dream. I am a proud, lifelong Democrat, and I will not allow them to do to me what they did to Hillary Clinton. As your mayor, I will stand up for you and make sure Rochester plays a leading role in the resistance to racist, homophobic, sexist, and wrong policies. After all, my 6-year-old daughter, Taylor, and all the other children across our city are still the reason why I'm asking you for your support in my run for re-election. You see, when you have a mayor who was also a mother, you have someone who isn't just worried about the next election or running for some other office. When you have a mayor who is also a mother, you get a leader who will fight every day to make this city a place where all of our children can grow up to realize their full potential. Rochester, we said we would, and we did. And with your help, we will forge ahead for another 4 years of job growth, another 4 years of safer, more vibrant neighborhoods, another 4 years of better educational opportunities for every resident of our city. Thank you all for believing in me. Continue to believe in our city. May God bless you all, and may God continue to bless the city of Rochester and all of its people. Thank you so much for coming.
How you doing?
You